Welcome, my political friends of the interwebs. Well, if you're like me, this story will piss you off. Florida is suing the federal government over voter purge. Okay, here's the skinny on this. Sometime last year, the state of Florida decided to look into the registered voters in the state, and the whole purpose of that was to try to figure out if everybody was a citizen, a legal citizen, able to vote. Okay. Well, when they did is they checked the driver's licenses against the voter of the voter logs and found out that somewhere around 182,000 registered voters may not have been U.S. citizens. Okay, there was a red flag there, clearly. So what they wanted to do was they wanted to utilize the United States database. Because apparently we have a federal immigration database. Okay, so they basically wanted to compare, verify against that. Well, of course, the Department of Homeland Security said no, there won't be any verification of who is a citizen or a non-citizen for voting privileges. I mean, If it's not Eric Holder, here's the thing that kills me, okay? It's so freaking blatant that the Democrats are counting on illegals to vote for Obama in order for him to get reelected. I mean, don't get me wrong. This ain't 4 years ago. They know they're in trouble. Obama knows he is in trouble, okay? But to so blatantly... whether you believe in open borders, don't believe in open borders, you know, I'm not going to argue that, okay? Although I think if you don't, I mean, if you're one of those people that basically, let me put it to you like this. If you are an open borders person, okay, most everybody that hasn't been living under a rock over the last 20 years remembers the movie Titanic. Well, there's a famous scene in there. That supposedly was true. There was a woman named Molly Brown. Soon she was nicknamed the unsinkable Molly Brown. Anyway, she's in a lifeboat, and they can hear the passengers that didn't get to be in lifeboats screaming. They're in the water, very, very cold water, and they can hear them screaming. And the women were like, "Look, we've got to go rescue. Those are our men. Those are our husbands. We've got to go rescue them." And the guy that was from the Titanic crew basically said, "Look, they'll swamp this boat and we'll all die." and that's really what to me it's almost like it illustrates how crazy open borders are. Because you can't if you don't have borders, you don't have a country. And let me tell you something, for those of you who believe in open borders, nothing good comes from that. You'll have a lot of people utilizing services and not paying for it, you know, and it's not sustainable. You have to have order, you have to have borders. Otherwise, it's just, everything's just one giant clusterfuck. That's just the way it is. And we all die, just like at the Titanic, we all die. So, but even let's say you're okay with that, you know, let's just say you're okay with that, you know, there's just something very wrong with allowing people that are not citizens of the United States to be able to vote, period. I mean, especially when you consider to vote for president of the United States, okay? When's the last time any citizen of the United States got to vote for the French president or the Mexican president for that matter? Now, it wouldn't shock me if there were people living in the United States that voted for both the president of Mexico and the president of the United States. But I mean, you know, it's simple. How many people that live in the United States voted for Putin over in Russia? I mean, you know, and let me tell you something. If you went over to Russia and tried to vote illegally for him, you'd end up in jail. It's thoroughly disgusting to me that the federal government is so they don't even try to hide it anymore. They're so blatantly pro-open border. They're so blatantly pro-illegal immigration, you know, and for reasons that are pretty obvious, okay? These people that come here are all voting Obama, flat out. He's so convinced that that's going to be the case that it doesn't even concern him that when he comes out for pro-gay marriage, knowing that the majority of the Hispanics coming from the southern border, the illegally coming to the United States, the majority of them are Catholic. You know, and I'm here to tell you the Catholic religion is not down with gay marriage. It's just not. You know, so I mean, Obama is so convinced that these illegals coming across the southern border are going to vote for him, it doesn't even matter what he says. And he's right. I mean, I'd say he probably is spot on with that. You know, but bottom line, he needs the illegal vote, and especially when you're talking about Florida. I mean, that's a key state. Florida has always been. Florida, Ohio, you know, we're talking key states here. And you know what? The more illegals, the merrier. Think about this for a second. Okay, now, what the state of Florida did, and they found 182 registered voters who may not be U.S. citizens. Think about this for a second. Think back to the election of George Bush versus Al Gore and how close that was. You know, I mean, can you imagine? And then I'd be very curious to know how many illegals were down there voting then and voting for Al Gore. You know, there's just something about illegals that love to vote for Democrats. I don't know. I mean, it's really kind of sad if you think about it, because the Democrats, as a rule, okay, have always tried to maintain a permanent underclass. I don't know if you've ever heard that before or not. I didn't originate this theory, but I definitely subscribe to it. The Democrats need a permanent underclass. They need people that will always be reliant on them, will always be looking for that government check. They need that. Whereas the Republicans are all about, you know what, pull yourself up by your bootstraps. If you need a helping hand, we'll give you a helping hand, but it's not going to be a way of life. We're not going to put you on a government check the rest of your life. And here's the thing. In the long run, the majority of the people will do better under a Republican philosophy when it comes to that. Because I will tell you right now, if you give a man a check, you will ruin his life. You know, especially when you consider, you know, the Democrats, when they put you on a check, it isn't like they're putting you on $100,000 a year. No. They're putting you on, you know, $10,000 a year, if that. But $10,000 a year plus a little food stamps and some cheap-ass government crappy housing with cockroaches. That's your life. That's your life under the Democrats' plan. But they need that. They need that permanent underclass. And here's the thing about the Hispanics. Okay, now this is just my theory, you know. But these aren't lazy people. These are not people that come here because they want to get on the government dole. I really believe that. I believe that the Hispanics that are coming across the southern border of the United States illegally are coming here for opportunity. They're coming here for jobs. They're coming here for a better life for them and their families. They're very family-oriented people. You know, in fact, a lot of the money that they make, a lot of it they send home to their families in Mexico. You know, I mean, that's, you know, the whole concept of family, the whole concept of working, the whole concept of trying to better your position in life. Those are Republican values. Those are Republican values. You can argue that with me if you want, but you'd be flat out wrong. You know, those are Republican values. And the sad thing about it is that they come here, they get it in their head that the Democrats are for the working man, the Democrats are for the poor. And in reality, the Democrats are awful. Yeah, they're for the poor, right? But they need you to stay poor. They're not looking for you to ever crawl out of a hole, because that's not going to work for them. You know, because what they're buying is a lifetime voter is what they buy. They buy a lifetime voter. And the sad part about it is they get that voter cheap. Cheap. You know, and for the rest of that voter's life. Literally, listen, you sign up for the Democrat plan, you've signed up for a miserable life. It's exactly what you've done. You've signed up to become part of the permanent underclass in this country. And it's the sad truth of it. And I know there are people out there that are like, what? No, that's bullshit. It isn't bullshit. Look around you. We have been fighting Lyndon Johnson's war on poverty for how long now? You know, it's got to be the only war in the history of human civilization where there's not even been as little as a skirmish one. Think about it. I mean, you know, where's the victories in this war on poverty? You know, there is none. But the Democrats figured out that if you create this permanent underclass, if you give people just enough money to keep their nostrils above water, they'll vote for you. And they'll always vote for you. And their kids will vote for you. And their grandkids will vote for you. It'll become generation after generation after generation of poverty inflicted on them by the Democrats. And it's almost like a Stockholm syndrome, where the person who's got you kidnapped, the person who's holding you at gunpoint, the person who's holding you hostage, is the person that you end up loving. It's sad. It's really, really sad. So, to get back to the voter deal in Florida, I think it's ridiculous that the federal government, we need to demand that the federal government allow the state of Florida to use their database to purge people off the voter rolls that do not belong on the rolls. If you are not a citizen of the United States of America, you do not get a vote. End of story. There is no ifs, ands, or buts. That's not a gray area. It's flat out simple. You are not a citizen, you don't get to vote. I don't care. I don't want to hear it. You don't get to vote. Now, if you're a Democrat watching this video, and I know I get a couple of them that do, state a case why you think illegal aliens should be able to vote. Because I'd love to hear it. I just love to hear it. All right, everybody, take care.